Well, we are in spring, of course. Of course, we haven't passed the freeze-free date, which is about April 20th. Haven't certainly passed the frost-free date for all of our annuals, but there is a lot of stuff. As long as you can work the soil outside, you know, planting trees and shrubs is something that you can certainly do. But some things to remember. Now, fall is probably one of the best times to plant because you have that extended period where the ground cools and the air temperature gets cool. The problem is we don't have as much of available nursery stock in all the stores. So that makes spring, so the earlier you get in the ground, the better off that it's going to be. Now, be aware, though, sometimes even our store, like, we'll get stuff in from the West Coast. So you can probably see that's not what something in our landscape is going to look like. This is a laurel. So we had that shipped in from the West Coast. So some plants can be a little sensitive if we get a cold snap. So kind of be aware of those. But certainly things in the garden center that haven't leafed out, those have been spending their winter here, probably in the Midwest or another cold location. So a few of the things that you need to remember when you plant. Planting a plant, you want to dig the hole twice as wide as the ball. So the other thing, you want to look at the roots, and you want to kind of disturb these roots, because if they're going around in a circle, that can be bad when you put in the hole. They're going to keep girdling like that. So you kind of disturb the roots a little bit. The hole is twice the size, and you want to plant, you got to make sure you don't make it into a valley where the water is going to go down there and hurt this. So you want to make, if anything, plant it a little high. Now, I've seen some landscapers that don't even dig a hole. They just sit it on the ground and mulch up on it. I wouldn't do that, but I would certainly leave 20% up out of the ground on some of the smaller shrubs. So you do that. Then the big question always is, well, should I add soil in? Should I put some organic matter in? Two schools of thought. You put too much in there and make it nice, and the child doesn't want to leave home. They live in the basement forever. But so if you use organic matter. The other way thinking is, if whatever you take out of the hole, you put back in, and it has to live in the soil that's there. So as long as you get the hole nice and wide, you can probably put a little bit of organic matter. Be careful of fertilizer. Do not fertilize. Certainly putting that down in the hole can be death to a plant, because the roots can pick up a nitrogen, and it can be a problem. Now, on the flip side, products like Biotone and Quick Start, from those can be, those are advantageous, especially as the temperature gets a little warmer, to help the plant adjust. Same thing with trees. Sometimes in the pot, the soil can be up. See the root flare? That root flare needs to be exposed. So you want to make sure that you plant the root flare above the soil line. And then when it comes to the other thing that we go crazy on, that we our love affair with mulch. So when you're mulching is great because it holds moisture, but don't go mulching up on top of the trunk. That's fine, come way out with it, but leave that root flare alone because it's bad for the tree. All right, there's things you can do in the garden.